So good evening, everyone. We are summer interns under fundamental research group, namely Suraj Goyal, Saurav Vijay, and myself, Anzum Bano. So we are here to give presentation on a very interesting project we are working from past 7 weeks, that is micro cloud setup using OpenShift. OpenShift, it is basically platform as a service which provides an easier way to develop, create, or deploy your containerized application. So the next question arises that why are we doing this project? What's the significance of this project? So deployment of apps is a very basic requirement in IT industries. Every now and then we need to deploy some apps. So the existing servers make this process a little complicated and a little time taking and effort taking. So why not make this process a single click away? You just click and you get the app deployed. So basically we are trying to implement the same thing using OpenShift. It also provides some additional features like auto scalability and portability. So how we are achieving this, we are using by two methods we can deploy. One is using command line interface or using OpenShift console that we will show in the later part of presentation.
So good evening all. I am here to discuss about why we have used OpenShift and how OpenShift has made things easier for us. So our object of the project is basically to set up micro cloud architecture with commodity storage and server nodes using OpenShift. So as we have mentioned earlier, OpenShift is an open source hybrid cloud platform application, which is actually a platform as a service. So OpenShift is used here to provide infrastructure for the orchestration of the dockerized images of various applications. So what is OpenShift like? What we were lacking earlier, and what is OpenShift providing that features? Firstly, by using OpenShift, we can provide all the access to one person, to a developer. Like he can create the application, he can modify the application, and he can deploy the application according to the demand of users at any time with just the execution of a single line command. By using OpenShift, we can make applications more portable and more scalable. Application can be made portable using OpenShift with Delta Cloud API, and application can be scaled as well. Like if there are higher user traffic at some day, so we can scale up our application. If there are relatively lower user traffic, we can accordingly scale down our applications. And moreover, OpenShift is used to provide the security and other extra features by containerized code and data in different containers. And OpenShift is used to speed up deploy of dockerized images of application. So in our project, we have used these technologies. First, it is shell scripting. Like we use shell scripting to work around OpenShift CLI. Second one is Git. Git has been used to fetch our application source code from remote repo, Ansible script. So to configure OpenShift, we need Ansible script. Docker and Kubernetes has been discussed by the previous project team.
Good evening, everyone. Basically, openedX platform is an open source online MOOC platform. So these are the few major components of openedX platform. And as discussed by earlier projects, I'm skipping it. And these were the containers that were deployed during DevStack installation of OpenShift. DevStack installation is the Docker-based installation of OpenShift, openedX. No, sir. This was on local system. These containers were deployed on local machine. So next we come to our OpenShift cluster. OpenShift basically uses the Kubernetes masternode architecture. And apart from the masternode architecture, it provides various features like OpenShift registry, OpenShift routing layer. In our project, we set up a cluster on four machines. Masternode, InfraNode, and two other nodes were set up. These are the configuration of nodes in our cluster. So this is the architecture of our deployed cluster. We had one master node, one infra node, which contains OpenShift registry, OpenShift router, and persistent storage. And we had two other worker nodes. So the applications were exposed to outside world through the routing layer.
So after the setting up of nodes and installation of OpenShift, we moved on to our next step, that was openedX installation. For this, we converted the Docker Compose file of openedX using Kubernetes Compose to various YML files like LMS service, browsers like Chrome, Firefox, and dependencies like MySQL and Django and DB. We tried to deploy these services. For this, we needed persistent storage. We created them using NFS server, and we needed persistent storage because we don't want that when our app has finished its working, we lost all our data. We wanted our data to be persistent. Then we had various images which we pulled from the Docker Hub and then pushed them into our OpenShift registry. And then using deployment config, we have deployed these apps. So this is how we deployed OpenEdX, but still we are lacking. What we are lacking here is the provisioning. Means we tried various method of provisioning. We also tried our hands on Arnold, that is tool provided by OpenFun. One way is that manual provisioning, but it is not a very good option. So we are still working on that. And later we got many more errors, like handshake is a very common error. We got system problem that we can't do things on our own system because of hardware requirements. So this is how we resolve them. This is what error, unable to perform provisioning step. Our result was same. We were able to deploy various services. We will show the demo now, like Ruby, PHP. We were able to deploy them successful. OpenEdX just provisioning step is lacking. And then our future goal is that cover up that provisioning step and also do the deployment using Arnold.
So the major step is the provisioning step, the provisioning of OpenEdX platform. The last step that is in DevStack. So the provisioning step is done by going to each container. And in OpenShift, each container is present on pods. So there is a.
So, but the Kubernetes, the one which they have used, the same Kubernetes is present here.
Yes, sir.
Which is not different, same version.
Sir, the same problem we are facing.
Where is the problem? Because they have been able to deploy it.
No, sir, we can deploy it.
Provisioning there also.
Mm-hmm. So then, what is the problem?
Sir, basically, they are also facing the provisioning problem. And
no, that is, they have a.
They have done it by going to each container.
Problem, yeah. I mean,
they have done it manually.
Configurations are required, network configurations.
The networking between containers, which are inside the pods, are very complicated.
Hmm.
Like,
complicated means what?
Like what? The architecture doesn't explain correctly the networking.
So you may have to define a network, no? Network. Yes. So what kind of network? What is the subnet? What masking you want? All those things should be there, right?
Yes.
So that's an SDN.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
This is the Ruby app that we deployed. Currently there are three ports, and we can scale up by just a single click. The four ports are deployed, and the application is successfully deployed. Ma'am, we have deployed LMS, but we weren't able to do provisioning step. So, yes.
So this web console is running on the master node. One last time. These are some of the services and deployments. DevPy, LMS, Mongo, and MySQL. Yes, ma'am. We can show you deployments, running services, status, memory, storages, persistent volume claims, but we were not able to provision. So all the PVCs. Is it, these are the PVCs.
provisioning is how much part of the work exercise. You said 10% work is remaining or 20%
work? 10 to 20%.
Yes, ma'am. 10 to 20% work. Thank you all.